Shalom Aleichem. We're in Lekutei Halachot, first halacha, and waking up in the morning, section 7. And when we say Parashat HaKorbanot, when we read Parashat HaKorbanot on the sacrifices from the Chumash, from the Bible, it's like we sacrificed them, like that our holy sages said in the Gemara Menachot 110, page Aleph, first page. Every person who learns Torah Olah on the sacrifices, so it is as if he sacrificed the sacrifice of Olah. Because the main way to correct, the main correction of sacrifices is in the aspect of the power of speech. To uplift the sparks from all the from creation, from flowers, from plants, from physical things, from life, to talking. Talking is a human being. That's the highest level of them all. Because the good points, those are the sparks. When they are rising from the place that they are rising, let's say that the sparks are now installed, they are inside the animal or something like that. And when the person in purity, in holiness, as a messenger of the Creator, doing the will of Hashem and sacrificing that animal in the way that we were commanded to do so, by that the sparks are being elevated from the animal to the one who has the power of speech, the man. So when those sparks are rising from the place that they are rising from the lowest levels up, and the main elevation is that they will rise to the aspect of speech. Because in the beginning, when still the good is not clear, when you cannot find the good point because of the bad that is covering on it, then it's in the aspect of a mute, a person that is mute. The good is mute, is not able to express itself, that he does not have a speech. Means that it's hidden and it cannot be expressed. When there is something good inside of that plant or inside of that animal, there are certain aspects of that goodness that is treasured inside of the animal that cannot be expressed through the animal itself. Only when it will rise to the aspect of a human being that he is able to speak, means to use those sparks that he elevated from the animal into himself and to then speak by that power, to use those sparks as speech. By that, the mute sparks are finding their way, they find a way to express, to be expressed. In the aspect of what it's written in Tehillim, Ne'elamti Dumiya, I was quiet, silent and quiet, hecheshiti mitov, and I was quiet from good. Means that the good was not able to be expressed when I was quiet. And when we reveal that goodness, like we explained, so then that is the main way of the good to reveal itself and to rise. And it's rising in the aspect of the power of speech, the main way of expression. And that is the aspect of what it is written in the Song of All Songs, Shir HaShirim. Yonati b'chagvei hasela b'seter hamadrega. My dove, the dove is in the cracks of the rock, in the hidden places of that level, in the hidden places. That is the aspect of the good point, that it's in the aspect of the dove, innocent dove. That she is innocent with her mate, with her couple, and she never let him go. It's a known thing that our sages said that the doves, they have their soulmate and they are not mating with others. So we can see that she is innocent, that she has something good in her, that dove, that she is loyal to her husband, and her husband is loyal to her. Because the good point that there is in everyone, even in the lowest one of all lowest ones, is always attached to Hashem Itbarach, to the Creator, always, no matter where it's at. And when it's falling, God forbid, into to even God forbid, to the depths of the husks that are surrounding it from every side, in the aspect of what it's written on that dove, that she is hiding in the cracks of the rock, in the hidden level, in the hidden place. So it means that she is hiding in the most hidden place of them all. It means that she cannot be seen, that she is totally covered. Then Hashem Yitbarach is saying to her, Har'ini et mar'aich, show me your sight, let me see you. Hashmi'ini et kolech, let me hear your voice. Ki kolech arev, because your voice is pleasant. U'mar'ech naveh, and the way you look and your sight is pretty. You look nice. So Hashem is praising her. Because even though that you are, every person in his level, in that hidden place, in that hidden level, beseter hamadriga, even though you yourself, even though that you feel like you're hidden, you feel that you are, that your light is not shining, the real truth is that you yourself, you're very nice, you're very handsome, you're very beautiful. In the aspect of what we learned, shechora ani venava, I'm dark, but I'm still beautiful. And therefore, you should reveal yourself and show your sight, because still you are very handsome, you're very beautiful, because the good point inside of you, it's beautiful always. And therefore, har'ini et mar'aich, show me your sight, let me see you. Hashmi'ini et kolech, let me hear your voice. Hainu, it means, shetegale, that you will reveal and find the sights of goodness, of the good point inside of you. And by that, you're going to express your voice. You're going to express it through your sound, your voice. Hashmi'ini et kolech. Because by that, you'll find the power of speech. Because then you can talk and thank and praise God, Hashem Yitbarach. Because earlier you were not able to talk at all because of your shame, because of your low self-esteem. But now, after that explanation, we can understand the next verse as well. Hayoshevet baganim, the one who sits in the gardens. Friends are listening to your voice. Let me hear it as well. And Rashi, the commentary, said, Hayoshevet baganim, the one who sits in the gardens, among the nations, means that it's the aspect of good points, that they are sitting and laid down between the nations, that they are the nations. Like we know, there is a difference between the nation of Israel to the rest of the nations. And the difference is that when we accepted on ourselves the yoke of heaven, to accept on ourselves to serve Hashem and to listen to His words and to follow His commandments, the contamination of the ancient snake that contaminated Adam and Eve and all human race stopped from us, from the nation of Israel. The nation of Israel were the only nation, and still are the only nation, that their contamination stopped for the time that we accepted on ourselves the yoke of heaven, the light of the Torah, to follow the rules of the Bible and the commandments and the explanation of the commandments of the holy sages. So the rest of the nations, even though they have many good points in them, every nation with their qualities and with their amazing talents that they've been blessed with and wisdom, but still there is something impure that is holding them back for generations, that the nation of Israel were blessed in the time of Mount Sinai, when we received the Torah, to be purified from. So while the nation of Israel that has a certain purity in them are sitting among the nations, between the nations, so the nations, they are reflecting to that aspect the lusts and desires and defaults, that they are the aspect of the rest of the nations of the world. Like that it's written in Siman Lamed Vav, in Torah 36. And Hashem Yitbarach, the Creator, desiring their voice. And that's why that it's written, friends are listening to your voice, please let me hear it. Because Hashem Yitbarach, the Creator of the universe, desiring that the good points will reveal, and that the nation of Israel will will raise their voice in praises and thanks to him, to Hashem Yitbarach. And that's the aspect of sacrifice, that we are rising those good points to the aspect of speaking, of power of speech. And therefore, the person who learns the Torah of sacrifices, so it is as if he sacrificed those sacrifices, because the main correction of the sacrifice is in the aspect of the power of speech, like we learned. For me, it's very important to mention that thing every time, hopefully, that we're going to speak about it, that if you think to yourself that you are not part of the nation of Israel, so I'm asking you, so why in the world are you listening to my videos? Why do you have that inner passion to learn Torah? Why do you love the nation of Israel? Why do you care about what I have to say? If not that there is a spark inside of you that relates you to that ancient wisdom. So think about it. Your history is something that is not totally, completely clear to you. You're not really aware of the roots of your family tree. So, of course, that you might have Israeli blood in your system. You can check your DNA and you'll find some treasures over there. And therefore, the soul of Israel that lives inside of you is the part of you that desires the Torah and true knowledge on the Creator's existence, on the Holy Land and the children of Israel. May Hashem bless you. Don't feel apart. Feel one with us and everything will come up to the good. Thank you for the good. Be good. Be well.
RDMC with the Emuna Project, all the nations with me. Close your eyes, just breathe, see the truth. Don't chase the fake world, don't buy the fake news. Be yourself, your own true self. Don't let no one take our natural wealth. See the good, no fear, no despair. Cherish who that you are and share.
Source of power from an endless spring. Light of courage in yourself, yes.
They can kick you down to the ground. Hold yourself up till you are put up your crown. King of the Creator, holy soul inside. Focus on the Spirit.